Hello everyone, my name is Maulik Pandya. We have another teammate, Ashwarya Makwana. Today we are going to talk about the environmental impact assessment on Palm Islands of Dubai. So let's begin.
Hello everyone, before moving on to our main topic, let me tell you some details about Palm Island. It mainly consists of three artificial offshore islands, which are Palm Jumeirah, Palm Jebel Ali and Deir Islands, which are located on the coast of Dubai, that is in United Arab Emirates. So let's see some details about these three islands, starting with Palm Jebel Ali. It has a similar archipelago like Palm Jumeirah and its construction began in 2006. Next is Deir Islands, which is four artificial islands linked to mainland by a bridge. Moving on to the third island, that is Palm Jumeirah. So, Palm Jumeirah is a tree-shaped island known for its glitzy hotels, posh apartments and upmarket global markets. Its construction began in 2001. Its area is around 5.72 km². It is also a site for private residences and hotels. Its population is around 10,500 as per 2011 census. The construction was done as a joint venture by two Dutch specialist companies, Van Oord and Westerlies.
As we all know, Palm Island is completely man-made island. So, how it's going to impact on our environment and how the marine life or aquatic life are going to suffer. So, let's see its impacts.
It was clearly visible that Dubai's artificial islands have high environmental costs. Even the World Wildlife Fund have made an announcement in 2006 declaring that United Arab Emirates' human footprints on global ecosystem are to be the highest in the world. They also stated that it is currently 5 times more unsustainable than any other country in the world. The other environment impact was there were 3 oyster beds which occurred in the investigated area, out of which one was lost during the construction process. However, Palm Jumeirah did not negatively impact any local fisheries. For the construction of this paradise, artificial reef systems were provided which are suitable and can substrate coral larvae to settle upon and to be grafted on it.
And the another impact is sedimentation rock, which is carried up continuously and has suffocated and injured the local marine life and also reduced the amount of the sunlight to directly the seashore of vegetation.
The artificial reef systems also have to withstand shamal currents, one of the reef which proved more efficient than concrete blocks or old cars and ships was Runde Reef. Due to this reef, marine habitat was again visible at nearby the island after few months of construction.
Now let's see the mitigation measurements. For the continuous watch or a check on aquatic life or marine ecosystems, the developers dives into the water at the duration of the 6 weeks on the regular basis. Even at the some areas, they have provided the large silt screen to minimize the turbidity. Even the developers are planning to build the largest reef structure for increase in marine life. After getting the success in this project, the another two islands projects has been started, named Palm Jebel Ali and Palm Dera Island.
As the construction began, the developers comes to know that it has the some kind of the fault in it, as it has the round circumstances around the whole island, which is may not allow water to move freely from one place to another. After the plenty of the meetings, the developers comes with the new design, in which they have decided to provide a little bit gap between the circumstances so water can move from one place to another without being stored at one particular place. So it is allowing the circulation of the water. It is not going to affect the coastal region or coastal line of the area.
Here in summer seasons, jellyfish used to frequent the beaches of Palm Islands. Due to the construction of artificial islands and human interventions, this drastically decreased the marine ecosystem around the surrounding. Around 2020, it was observed that the reduction of human activity due to COVID-19 led to an increase in marine ecosystem. For example, dolphins around the Palm Jumeirah Island were increased.
By this, we would like to end our presentation over here. The message that environment is no one's property to destroy. It's everyone's responsibility to protect. Thank you. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you very much.